so much assertive and aggressive to go anything beyond that. He said, you are giving nothing to me, nothing to me. You just earn your money. I will have this friend. He said, okay. Then the friend, he kept quiet. The friendship became so much. Let's see, one day decided to marry that person. And he agreed. He said, okay, come to India, I'll marry you. There was a day difference. So, without ever meeting him, she took the decision to leave Africa, leave that school, leave her children, and come to Mumbai. I mean, come to Delhi. En route, she came to Mumbai. And she had one day here, because there's some family here. One day, before going to Delhi, something happened in her mind. So, let me go and meet a psychiatrist. And let me ask the psychiatrist whether it is a proper thing that I am doing. Just that thought. So, from the dialogue, it was something she found my name and she came to Lilavati Hospital. So tomorrow I'm going to Delhi, but this is the story. I was shocked. Despite being, we are not supposed to be shocked at anything. We are not supposed to react. We are supposed to be objective, not be judgmental. But I was shocked. I said, what are you doing? This is 7 years younger. He is not even having a little bit of money that your husband has. You are married, you have two children, you are a principal of a school there. Your husband who is devoted to you, and this will never work. I was very upfront, and generally a psychiatrist don't talk like this. But then she said, only one day, because like this was going. So there was the only way I could have responded. I said, I don't think this is going to work. And she said, listen to me, and after we had discussion about this, that, and a lot of other things, she went to Delhi. She stayed for about 8 to 10 days with me. But that, end of that trip, the 10 days, she realized that this will not work. All that romance that was there put on Facebook, it is not going to work in real life. By that time, she had become matured, she is 42, she was running a school, she knew what money is, and this guy had hardly any money, and young fellow, and he was good to talk, but nothing more than that. So that shallowness which was there in him was very visible to her. So, she decided to end that. There's nothing there. So end there and then do what? She came to Mumbai and said, now what do I do? Again she met me. Because she told her husband, I'm going through marriage. You see, her problem is, now where do I go? Do I go back to my husband? She already told him that means she knew that he knew that she was having an affair. There is no choice now here. You can do nothing in Mumbai. There's nobody to support you. No money, no life. Please go back. We'll see what your husband does. He's a nice person. You will not believe me. He accepted. So, he was so compassionate. He said, I understand. He understand my shortcomings. So I can understand that you become attracted to that person. I understand I'm not good at sex. So you get attracted. But please stay. Out of his compassion, she developed love for him. After so many years of marriage. And that is the change that. Now I love my husband. The sex life is still not good. So I asked, there's a sex, but what sex? So I ended up in those 8 days when Delhi trip. I want no more of that. So the sex life is not good, but now she loves the husband. You always used to love her. And they are now staying together, happy. So these are some of the stories and some of the experiences that I have. And out of these experiences, if you want some similar tips, this is what I thought. This is the basics. There has to be compassion for your partner. It is very, very important that human relationship has to be founded on compassion. Then there has to be commitment, the relationship between husband and wife. That is how the trust will come. And finally, you just cannot exist because of a legal structure or social structure in today's world, it is not. So there has to be a companionship. If these three things are there, then it will lead to love, trust and intimacy. Other three things, how much you compromise. One survey was done and they found the most people who are staying there for a long time, a common attribute which most people attend, that is the highest number, compromise. How much a person is going to compromise. There are so many problems, so many flaws that your partner will have, so many problems that will come up, so many conflicts that you will not be able to resolve. What to do? If you want a marriage to be running, and you want a marriage to be happy, you have to learn to compromise. And it is not like equality, it doesn't mean 50-50. I have compromised this much, she has to compromise this much. No. One partner may have to compromise more, the other partner may compromise less. But the ability to compromise is a very important thing. communication effective. It's not just talking, but talking to get things done, talking to make things happy in your life. And there should be some common goals. Children have common goals, what we do, what do you want by our flag. Day-to-day life should have common goals that should drive you together. If there are no common goals, it's very difficult for the marriage to be at least happily existing. And beyond happy working relationship, there should be some musty in life. And as Dr. Mishra said, physical fitness. Very crucial, very important. Those who are fit, they're happier. If the things are working well, you see, if there's serious physical illness, or even a serious mental illness, it can really cause problems in the marriage. So if both the partners are physically fit, it will add to their thing. Sex, very important thing. If you're physically fit, you like sex, nothing like sex. The best sex is the sex in marriage. If there's a myth that sex outside marriage is more pleasurable than sex inside marriage. Totally wrong. The most enjoyable sex, pleasurable sex, because you know your partner so much that you like, he likes, she likes, how to do it this way. You do it with a new partner, you don't know. So the most pleasurable sex actually can be with your married spouse. Of course, financial sex, roti, kapda, makan, important thing to be happy. If you don't have this thing every day or one thing where you're going to stay, there's no flat. No, how to buy a new flat in Bombay and you bhaade ka jaga from one place to another every 11 months, you have to move with your children, it can really cause unhappiness. And finally, you have children, but yourself, you should be childlike. I mean, life is serious. I understand that and there are serious goals. But when you are with your partner, for some time you have to be childlike. And there are many couples that I know who are childlike when they are together. I have a very good doctor friend of mine. Wife is also a doctor. Both are super specialty. Both are working in Bilawati. Both are very good friends of mine. He tells me, whatever happens, whatever fights we have, at the end of the day when I sleep, he has to hug me, I have to snuggle. He has to snuggle me. If he doesn't snuggle me, I'll have another fight. So he has to snuggle me, only then I get sleep. So even after a bad fight, it is her rule. For sleeping, he has to snuggle. He says, if I snuggle her all my anger, it was there 10 minutes, make it all disappear. They also do a lot of masti together. They'll go out together on vacations alone, they'll go on trekking, and they'll go to parties and they'll wear in the fancy. So sometimes some people invite fancy dress parties and you wear this way, that way. They'll do all those things. Dandiyara, they'll go and play Dandiyara, like, you know, they're young people, and how they young people play Dandiyara. A lot of things they do which are childlike. If we remain there, then there can be a lot of. Thank you very much.